Well, I think Ted has done more to elevate the visibility of the problems with Obamacare and the effort to defund it than any other person I can think of. So I congratulate him for capturing the imagination of the American people and certainly their attention. But I am actually, Republicans are unified in our effort to defund Obamacare, which is why I support the House bill. In fact, Ted and Mike Lee and others were instrumental in getting the House to attach this to the continuing resolution that we now have before us in the Senate so we can actually vote on it. And what the difference of opinion is really about tactics within the family. I don't think
what did you not like about his tactics? Because he was said to have been very upset that you defected from his way of going about this.
Well, this isn't about personalities. I think this is about protecting the American people from the failure of Obamacare. And if Republicans don't support a bill that defunds Obamacare, I don't know how we explain that to the American people. And if we allow government to shut down, ironically, Obamacare still gets funded. So what I think a better approach is to put the pressure on Democrats who are running in 2014 from red states. We have a number of Democrats running in red states in 2014 and put them on the record again, as Senator McConnell said, and see if, you know, rarely in life do you get second chances, but this is a second chance to get right with the American people.
Yeah.
Or if they want to double down, it's going to be a big issue in 2014.
That's a really interesting issue. And we have that sound from Senator McConnell. Let's listen to that quickly if we could.
So this law is a mess. It needs to go. It's way past time to start over. And as I've been saying all week, we need just five brave Democrats to join us to make that happen. So I hope some of our Democratic friends who voted for this law will look themselves in the mirror and think, truly think, about whether protecting the president's pride is really more important than helping the American people.
So, Senator Cornyn, how would that work? What do you expect to happen when this goes back to the House? And then how would you, you know, at what point would you put that pressure on those five brave Democrats, as Senator McConnell calls them?
Well, the vote we're going to have this week in the Senate on the continuing resolution with the defunded provision attached, it's important that we not kill it by denying cloture on that bill, because why would you vote to kill a bill that you actually support? And that would then set up a process by which these red state Democrats would have to vote to strip Obamacare out of here, or perhaps they will have reconsidered, as Senator McConnell said, and realized that whether it's Richard Trumka and organized labor or just listening to their constituents in their states, Obamacare has not lived up to its promises. And it's time for us to work together to try to protect the American people from the failure of this misguided policy.
All right. Senator John Cornyn, thank you very much. Good to have you here this morning, sir.
Thank you.
Forget the